Good evening once again. My name is Pastor Kelvin Masharia. I love the Lord as my personal Savior, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross, not only for me, but anyone who believes. Allow me to pray before I begin this evening's devotion. Father, in Jesus' mighty and precious name, God, I just want to say thank you for the power of your grace. Thank you for your might, O God, that indeed, O God, even at the cross when you said, "It is finished," death could not overcome you. Lord, even in this devotion, I pray for the people who are watching tonight that, God, your word will reach out to their hearts. Your word will minister to all of us tonight. Your word will bring light to our path and a lamp unto our feet. Even as we walk around, may your word be the essence of what we live for. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. It's a wonderful time to have you back in this evening's devotion. I want to talk about a very interesting subject concerning affliction. And before even I begin that subject, I would like us to read from the book of Genesis chapter 15 from verse 13. Genesis 15 from verse 13 to 14. This is what the Lord says in his word. "Then he said to Abraham, 'Know certainly that your descendants will be strangers in a land that is not theirs, and will serve them, and they will afflict them 400 years. And also the nation whom they serve I will judge afterwards. They shall come out with great possessions.'" My subject to you tonight is about, I know your affliction. You see, in the book of Genesis chapter 15 verse 13, it begins by whereby God had revealed a certain event that would occur in the descendants of Abraham. Yes, Abraham was a friend of God. He was termed as a man of faith. But in his relationship with God, God managed to reveal certain deep things that would happen. You see, God here in verse 13, he states that your descendants will be strangers. And we do know for a fact that that came to fulfillment in the book of Exodus. And here God was saying, your descendants will be strangers in a land that is not theirs. And they will serve them, and they will afflict them 400 years. To the point whereby God had revealed the time span that they will be there. I want to acknowledge by the fact that in as much as we are facing this pandemic for the third wave, God knew that this would happen. It's not that God did not know that this would happen. One thing about God is that nothing has ever caught God by surprise. And here in verse 14, the importance of why God had revealed this to Abraham, it is because of this one thing. He said, "And also that nation whom they serve," these people, your descendants whom they will serve, those people, they will serve there 400 years. You can imagine 400 years is a lot of time. But in verse 14 it says, "And also the nation whom they serve," this is the purpose of why those descendants had to be in captivity for judgment. And here God talk about, "I will judge afterwards." He was going to judge that nation that was afflicting them. But go back to verse 13 of the same scripture. This is what the Bible says. It says this, "Then he said to Abraham, 'Know certainly that your descendants will be strangers in a land that is not theirs, and they will serve them.'" So in this regards, God knew that these people would be in captivity. God knew that these people would be afflicted. God knew that these people would be tortured. It's not that God did not know, but there was a bigger picture of why they had to be in such a state for judgment in Egypt. We do not know the reason why COVID is here. We have never known. But all we can do is pray that the Lord God will hear us from heaven, and he will have mercy on us, that we will be able to survive this event. Like I said before, nothing has ever caught God by surprise. And you must understand this. God had to reveal this to Abraham because of one thing. Not because of religion. Because of relationship. Now is the time for you to seek God. And maybe in your closet, maybe in your bedroom, maybe in your sitting room, regardless of where you pray in your house, that is the place where God will be able to reveal certain things as he did to his friend Abraham. And Abraham died at a very good old age, at 175 years old. But we do know for a fact, the reason that his descendants had to be in captivity was for one reason only: judgment upon that nation that was serving other gods. I believe that you are blessed tonight. And I do believe that whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world. Even our faith in him. Have faith in this time. We do not know why this pandemic is happening. But I do believe for a people who are seeking God diligently, God will reveal certain things that is transpiring and also that will transpire in the future. Until next time, may God bless you and keep you. Shalom.
Umetenda mema, ewe Bwana, ndo maana sisi twakutukuza.
Umetenda mema.
Kutukuza.
Umetenda mema, ewe Bwana, ndio maana sisi twakutukuza.
Tukuza jina lako Bwana.
Ewe Bwana, twakutukuza.
Tukuza jina lako Bwana.
Ewe Bwana, twakutukuza.
Tukuza jina lako Bwana.
Kutukuza.